And we are back. Asha is called the After Life Nonsense. My name is Dumasim. Better on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, 8 to 8:30 p.m. So before we went for the break, we're still talking about Eddy Kenzo. And how me, I think that, you know, Ugandans, you're kind of peaceful. I'm telling you, bruh. I'm telling you. I know you argue about President Museveni. You say yes, the country is sad. But a country whereby television stations and the whole country is consumed in a father, no, a pirao eating thing, abusing an artist. And that's a big story. And TVs are passing budgets to go meet this man at the airport. And we are all waiting for him to go to Chibuli. And that's urgent. And that's what we are all talking about. I'm talking about it. It's in the papers. It's on all blogs. Every newspaper is updating you about it. That's not really a sad country. Trust me, it's not a sad country. You might disagree, but it's the truth. Oh, like, let me just read some comments, and then we see what other people think about Kenzo coming back and everyone just being crazy over his coming back. Put up some comments. There is Daniel Viamukama. Some people are loved more than the president. That's really like how it has always been. Public figures are always loved more than politicians. Come on. That's what rocket science. Because public figures are not accountable to anyone. They don't have mandate. There's Chirunda Ben. That is what it means having a young and redundant society. People have jobs. People don't have jobs, I think, maybe. Daniel Biamukama again. Uganda is a bewitched country. Okay, Daniel Biamukama, we know you have a lot of words, but man, don't take up the whole comment section. Eh? Anyway, it's Birunji, Trishila, Sheila, to Chibuli Mosque, to Muchu Saplan. Yeah, he's even going to go there, really. Oh, man. You know what, man? I just try to understand, to make sense of whatever is inside. That's why propaganda will always win. People don't even know how they feel. People don't even know what they want. They are waiting for you to define who they are, how they feel. Somebody could have 40 million saved up on account, and then you tell them you're poor, and they're like, by that way. And then, propaganda is something else. Anyway, let's move on. Before I leave this place, because I'm almost time out, Andrew Mwenda. I know most of you don't know him. Lord. Andrew Mwenda said that he once considered running for president. Of what? The Talkers Association? The Annoying Association? The Offend People Association? You see, that's the thing about Andrew Mwenda. He's brilliant. No one can argue against that. He's intelligent. No one can argue against that. But his communication is too insightful. Don't think that President Museveni, is also smart, but the way he talks is different. Andrew Mwenda abuses, which is actually I don't understand. He comes and he says, oh, people power are extremists, and then he goes and he calls them demented fools, deluded, stupid, empty-headed. Like what? So Andrew Mwenda, if you are ever to run for president, you have in Uganda 3 votes. Your vote, the vote of your sister, Margaret Mahanga, and Kinirugaba, because both of you roll out like that. I don't even know why you are too close. But Kinirugaba, that depends. If Mozi, it's not a Friday, because if it's a Friday voting, we are voting on a Friday. Mozi has more important things to do. Oh, man. You want to run for president? Get out of here, man. Come on. You know yourself. You know how you speak. You cannot stand a chance. You are brilliant. You are a very good commentator, but you abuse and you're so emotional. Everything Mwenda has accused opposition of, he does. He says opposition is extremist, and Mwenda is extremist. He is yalokinga. You know locking. Yalokinga into this whole thing. And for him, he doesn't even see it, but yalokinga. He says opposition is abusive. He abuses. He calls opposition hooligans, and Manyasi Manyi, they play to people's sympathies and they like cheap publicity. He started up a rebel group of slay kings, light-skinned boys. Oh, where did he get them? But yeah, they're just there in the bush. Oh, you pity. Then they first slap themselves with mosquitoes. Bruh, no. Let me read some comments about Andrew Mwenda before I get out of this place. You see how people are reacting. There is Eric Chahasi. I think you are becoming overambitious, Andrew. Leave politics to the politicians. Just continue with the good work you are doing as a scribe. We are always getting a lot of information from your articles. You'd rather stick to writing, that my friend.
Veronica Namboa. Andrew Mwenda, you have become a billionaire and benefited much more in the Museveni and in the government, in the Museveni government, at the expense of people of the Uganda suffering. But Andrew Mwenda, even before he was praising Museveni, he was not a poor man. Kayaga Paven. But these people also from Kaguta to Mwenda, all passing Katuna border. God have mercy on Uganda, and we get a Ugandan to be our next president. Wait, this is treason. You are inciting that the president is not legal, he's not a citizen. Mercy. My best political analyst in Uganda, I wish to meet you physically, even because of your wisdom, words, your arguments, and your thinking inspires me a lot. Let me just stop at that. Like I said, Andrew Mwenda is a genius. He really is clever. Like, that just is clever. That's just there. But I don't think he has the qualities of a leader. No. Andrew Mwenda is a good commentator. But if he becomes a leader, Jesus, can you believe Andrew Mwenda? You know how many words he'll be saying? Can you believe, like, because Andrew Mwenda coming to give an address in parliament, and he talks until people run out of parliament and they come back and you find him still talking? That's why it's called the Unreliable Nonsense. Spirit out of Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday from 8 up to 8:30 p.m. Until tomorrow, have a very lovely night.